I'm on my way, man. Now I'm down, short down. Now I'm on my way, man. 46-40. Now I'm on my way, man. What more can I say? What more can I say, man? Now I'm on my way. Now I'm on my way, man. Now I'm on my way, man. Stuck with Orange Johnson, now it's all to the good. 6:40 evening show, man, it's all to the hood. Cornelius Green, that's the OG. He the one that got me plugged.
Now it's O-A-G-I-O, man, my music like a drug.
That's Scarlet and Gray all day. Did I mess up? I didn't talk about they really wanna stand around. 6:40, did it get shorty? Did I make the mama talk about she wanna get dying? Presidential, you a residential. Why you look at me like you really want that wall? If you know what I know, or if you do what I know, you be looking like brother. People be looking like he's putting down. Fire that I really admire. When I listen to the 46 or the 640, your honor, I'm a bomb like Sarah Connor. Did you even know what I am saying? There is a reason they call me this brother, because I am about to go super saiyan.
I said,
I'm a bomb like Sarah Connor. Did you even know what I am saying? There is a reason they call me this brother, because I am about to go super saiyan. The 640.
What's up, ladies and gentlemen? DJ 640, we back on the air. How y'all doing? How y'all doing? Yeah, it's 25 minutes, you know what I'm saying? You know, due to circumstances beyond our control, you know what I'm saying? We had a segment that was supposed to go before me that was supposed to be on for 20 minutes, but, you know, certain things didn't show up. So, out of the honor, of the respect that we do it each and every Thursday with the missionary Antoinette, I didn't want nobody to go on before her. I left that 20 minutes allotted for her, and this is just how we do it. It's a 6:40 evening show. We about to start this thing. Sweet 16, take me to the tip-top, baby girl, and let's get this thing started. I got the general in the building, too. Don't y'all go nowhere. Y'all keep it locked.
Hi, this is Destiny. You're now in tune to the 6:40 Evening Show featuring my daddy, DJ 6:40. Hey!
Gotcha. What's up? Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We're on the set. You live with DJ 640. Which one of these cameras am I supposed to be looking at, Ron?
One.
Okay. Hey, One. What's up with you? Because I don't like, it seems like I be looking cross-eyed to the camera. I got the monitors up here because, you know, I ain't so used to being here on time and everything like that because, you know, we got Missionary Antoinette that does the first segment part of our show to get us started right here, and I get all set up in here. But like that, you know, big shout out to her. She couldn't make it today, but, you know, hopefully everything will be on point for us for next week. And we just gonna do it like how we supposed to do it. As promised with you, like I know, we got a nice hot show for you today. I got the general himself up in the building, John Fox. They call himself the general. We dealing with street politics every day that we talking about, and he gonna give it to you live. He gonna let you know everything going on, what's up with it. So without no further ado, without no further delay, I'm gonna go introduce you to my guest right here. Mr. John, how you want me to introduce you? John Fox, you want me to introduce the general?
Hey, man, street politician general. Man.
Street politician general. You know, that's how we do, man.
Street
welcome
politician
to the 640
general,
show, man.
Nah,
thank you for coming
it,
up here.
Yeah, man.
Appreciate it.
I'm on all fours, man. I'm riding till the wheels fall off. You know what I'm saying?
For real, for real. Got you. I got you on that, man. You know, I respect the grind and stuff. You know, and you know, like I said on the previous Reddit, one of my previous shows that was on it, you know, you was able enough to come through here, man. I was like, you know, it's a good dude, man, and I be following you on your Facebook and everything like that. Yeah. And I know you got your ear to the streets and you be doing your thing. And, you know, this is the platform, and I definitely wanted to bring you into this thing on here. This is Vox Power right here.
Right.
And I want you to come on here and, you know, let the folks know, you know, what you got going on and what you're doing.
And I highly appreciate that. Yeah. I told you I love being in a good company.
Right.
You know, right now, you know, Street Politics, and we're working towards our mentoring program with the youth.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's hard because I'm sponsoring myself.
Gotcha.
So I got to get a 501c backer.
Gotcha.
To back me, I got a lot of organizations just trying to work with me, but I don't see that. Some of them, I just see them trying to just benefit, you know, piggyback off the work that I don't already done.
Okay,
you know what I'm saying? But we got music. My artist G5 just came home. I went and picked him up at the airport last night. This is the best. I'm talking about this guy right here. We was out there with Shy Glizzy. You know, when I first came through, didn't I explain the swag if I brought some of the music last time?
Right.
With him?
Right. Well, I actually had your CD last time.
Oh, okay, yeah. So this time, he back. We got new music. We're going to be working with Boo Boo, the producer. He going to produce the majority of the album. I'm trying to get HHEO. My young boys around Lincoln Heights, they working with him to produce. I'm trying to get that. Okay. I got a book that's about to come out. 1 and 2, everything I did good was all bad. You know what I'm saying? Explaining the life how DC youth come out the house living, thinking backwards.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Instead of, you know, trying to get education and going forth and trying to get a career, we come out the house robbing, hustling, selling drugs. And this is just a story loosely based around my life and the individuals who groomed me coming up. It's true. Got all paperwork in there. You know, because who best to tell them than one who's been through it?
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
That's what's up, man. So when is it going to be finished? It's finished and it's great getting to
it. It's finished. It's getting edited and typed up right now by Ghostwriter Inc. This is a company that did numerous books for artists like Anthony Fields. You know, so he got Gaddafi 1 through 5. You know, what I'm saying.
True.
You know, what I'm saying, and he put me on to them. So, you know, just networking. I love meeting and greeting people, trying to get more information, trying to get people together. Because, you know, that's what we basically about. We street politics. We networking with people.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? No negativity. You know what I'm saying? We ain't got time for the hate. We focus on love.
Right.
You know?
Yeah. Speaking of no technology, I was looking at your page today, man. Was tripping. You said, how could somebody be so busy when they home or something watching?
More. Yeah. Look. Yeah. I said that because this individual I know, right?
I get it. I get it. The Facebook thing, and you know, and so it let out some steam and stuff, and just, you know, they let it out. You know, I'm going for the cup on that one.
I don't understand it, man. You so tired. Every time I talk, I'm so tired. You ain't got no job. You just watch Moy all day. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But I had a debate with this young lady on Facebook, and it was a positive debate. You know what I'm saying? It kind of got into her emotions because I was saying that the state of our kids being bad.
Right.
So she sent me the definition of bad mean poor choice.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
You know, and I wanted to get that out. I reiterated some things to her that I work with kids. I help kids. You know what I'm saying? I mentor kids. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
I was a bad kid myself. You know what I'm saying? Don't take it too personal about me saying bad where you down in our kids. How I'm down in our kids? I'm telling you just what it is.
Right.
Because I was a bad kid. My mother did whatever she had to do for us, you know what I'm saying, to put a roof of food, you know, on clothes on our back. Right. And we still decided to sell drugs and hang in the street, that, you know, in past life, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
So that's my definition of being bad.
Yeah.
Now, she went off philosophy, you know, got technical on me and all this other stuff, talking about, this is what I mean about the education of African Americans, of black people, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
I'm telling her that when you sell, if you going out the house, you damaging your community selling drugs. You know what I'm saying? Because what that do? It's a snowball effect.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? If I sell drugs, the addict can't get it. What they do? They go commit a crime.
Right.
And what the poverty breeds crime.
Right.
You see what I'm saying?
Right.
So she tells me, oh, you're not looking at it right because a drug dealer is a businessman.
I can see it from both sides. You can see it from both sides, but actually, you know, it's been some success. They had some success.
Jay-Z, you know what I'm saying? Like, Jay, you got a couple of, you know, success stories out of that.
Right.
But imagine how much damage that is undone.
Exactly.
That's few and far between.
Exactly. Right. That's what I'm saying. 6 and 1/2 and half a dozen of them. You know, it's the same thing, you know, looking at it both ways. And And from your, you know, you got some good, some pretty good viewpoints and stuff like that. But see, and, you know, from the average Joe, it's like I say, it's being on your page again and following, like I said, mm-hmm. you know, because I'm saying, well, you know, street politics and all that like that. Because one of your stories was you were, one time you was at a gas station, you know, then I'm saying somebody asked you for some change, and then you say, I don't have it. Then they all in your hand because you gave it to some kids that mm-hmm. was selling some, that's was selling
that
some.
That was pumping gas.
Right, yeah. right. Like, and you know what I'm saying? You're doing it for them. It's like, man, you know, what you doing in my hand? I said, I ain't had nothing to give. You know, why are you all in my business?
Right,
you know
right, right. Saying? Exactly, right, exactly.
Right. So, you know, you, I'm saying, man, like, I'm a big supporter of yours, man. You know what I'm saying? With the things and stuff that you're doing and with the, and the what you're doing with the kids and stuff like that, the mentor and everything, man, you know, just, I want you to just keep that thing up, keep it going, and anything else here that we can do here to help. I wish Big T was here, because he's also a big fan of your Fox, and he wanted to be here today, but he couldn't be here today due to other circumstances that he's doing with his kids and stuff today, but,
yeah.
you know, maybe I get him a chance to call in or something and say what's up to you, something like that, but he's also a big fan. Big shout out to my man, Big T. Also, you got another project coming on here with yourself that you're doing some music too, man. And I definitely want to get some of that on. What's
yeah,
up with that?
I got my artist just came home, G5 Weez. You know what I'm saying? This one of the few artists that I this guy so extraordinary, and his genius is so extraordinary. He don't even write nothing down, man.
Oh yeah. He just go off the top of his head.
This guy doesn't even, and he can remember like an elephant. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So with that, I try to, you know, I try to perfect his craft. You know what I'm saying? Like he come out the streets. I'm talking about heavy on East Street. You know
okay.
what I mean? I actually pulled him out the neighborhood because one time they was beefing so hard. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? I was afraid he was gonna get shot.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So me with my, you know, my street clout,
mm-hmm.
I went in there holler at some the big boys.
Right.
And squash the beef, get him up out there. I need him. You know what I'm saying? Not just him for his artistry, but just him as an individual. He's got a good heart.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And that's what us men need to do more. When we see this,
yeah,
we need to, you know, harvest it. You know what I'm saying? We need to plant them seeds so it can grow into something. You know what I'm saying? Don't right. let it die out. Water that plant.
Right, because you see that potential.
Yeah,
right.
yeah, yeah, I see that right. potential. You know what I'm saying? Right. Like the older dudes when I was growing up, like, I know a couple of dudes, they don't send dudes to college.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Right. They don't do that no more in the neighborhood. You know what I'm saying? Right. Get off the script. You're too good to be on the script. Mm. Let's go. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
That's why we created Street Politics. And when the last time I seen you, I'll be honest about it, we were still yeah. living and dabbing. You know
I
what I'm saying?
You. I feel you.
But, you know, recently I just got shot 4 times.
Wow.
You know what I'm saying? Almost died. Got a video of it. You know what I'm saying? And it gave me just a sight, you know. I was coming home,
damn.
Pulling up, and I seen two dudes. And when I seen the black mask, I already knew what it was.
Right.
I started running. It shot me 4 times. I hit the head, shot in my hand, shot in the back, and shot in my butt.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? It broke my tailbone. So it made me gain weight, being in the hospital, not being able to exercise. And that just gave me time to think.
Damn, Fox, yeah, yeah, right.
Do a lot of thinking. Like, you know, no matter how much you feel like you love, like, people hate you, man, for doing stuff in the community. I've been gone 17 years. So mm-hmm. when I come back and give to the community and assist people, don't get mad at me because this is what you supposed to been doing.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
I feel you.
And it creates a crevice. It creates a, you know, a gap because they don't understand where you coming from. You don't want to take part of that negative activity no more.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
You want to progress and grow, level up.
Right.
McMill says levels, and it's actually levels it because one of my friends, he got a 10-bedroom mansion in Atlanta.
Okay.
I just went down there to visit him. He took me to meet Rollo. And, you know, and when we was pulling out Rollo Complex in the Bluff in Atlanta, Southwest Atlanta, Future was pulling it.
Really? Straight up?
Man, 3 Aventadors, man, 4 race back to back, everything all black, man. And I was just like, dang, man, these dudes come from the street. Look how they living now.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Even though the Bluff or where the complex is still in, you know, the ghetto, but this guy bought the whole complex.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? I'm quite sure you probably heard of dude, Rollo. Shout out to Rollo Goon, Fam Goon, man.
Okay.
You know, this dude, man, he bought the whole complex. And look, got brothers out there working,
mm-hmm.
doing landscape, carpentry, you know, building more houses. That's inspiring.
Right, that's what it's all about.
Yeah,
right.
yeah. Okay. You know what I'm saying? Building up your community.
Right.
If you ain't doing that, I wouldn't be a big homie.
Right.
So, that, and I got that project. The Screech Will Kill Your Lynch was a new song we did. People ask, why, Fox, why are you still doing music? I mean, it's an expression of art. Right. I mean, that's where, you know, you get to express yourself, you know what I'm saying? You want to be heard. That's your voice right there. You know what I'm saying? And they're like, golly, but you got so much else going on, you know what I'm saying? That's my segue to the youngest. They love music, so when they hear my music, oh, that's good. Pull them in.
Right.
Find out their potential and talent. And try to harvest that. You know what I'm saying? I don't care. It don't have to always be music, but we got to have something that connect us, mm-hmm. you know, so we can be able to communicate.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
And you're a good advocate for that, man. And because, you know, I think a lot of folks and you, if they are doing it already, which I'm quite sure they're probably doing because with your success with the street politics, is that, you know, a whole bunch of stuff that you've done and you've been through. Like, I remember the job that you had before, and then you know, come like a week later, they found out some negative stuff on you. Then you know they put you down, and you had to fight for that. And actually, you was on TV talking about that. That was like a couple years ago.
Yeah,
right?
No, that was just year before last. I attained my CDL.
Right.
Because you know, I'm an open book. I got murder cases. You know what I'm saying? So my murder case is over with though.
Right.
So I say, look. They keep stigmatizing me with being, you know, like you a felon, I went and got my CDL.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Did everything they asked me to, you know, to do. And when I finally got the job, I saved this lady life on the bus. She was having a seizure.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? I picked her up, took her to the bench, gave her some water, waited till the engine 5 came, ambulance came along, picked her up. And she was elated that I did that and wanted my name and stuff. So when she reported the supervisor wanted to know who was I, because in their 13-year history, they never had nobody to respond like that.
True.
You know what I'm saying? But my brother had seizures.
Right.
So I knew how to respond immediately.
Right.
You know? And they called me back to the office and fired me. I thought it was, you know, they were going to give me a reward or something.
Like,
yeah,
because right,
I was like,
right,
oh, yeah, you know what I'm saying? I'm doing a good deed and service. Said, man, you no longer can be able to work here because you're a felon. You're an ex-felon. Man, it hurt me. I said, you know what? You know, the dependents might have been the sword, so take it to, you know, the courts, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And that's what I did.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, we waiting on the decision now from them people. Just put it like that.
I got you.
Yeah.
I feel you like that, man. But like I said, man, you know, it's like, you know, your heart and everything is in the right place, man, and your spirit, man. Let you know, I definitely appreciate that, man. I appreciate your grind because, you know, no matter what obstacles come your way, you know what I'm saying, you always keeping it going, you always pay it forward, you know what I'm saying, and you continue to do your thing, man. I just want to let you know, I commend you for that, man. And then, you know, just, you know, I want you to keep, you know, just keep that up, man. You know, don't be discouraged, which I already, it's easy for me to say, but I'm just letting you know, just, you know, don't be discouraged with that, man, and keep that grind going on, man. Keep on doing what you're doing.
It can, I think, like, it can only get better from here if you got to just stay persistent. With it, stay consistent. See, that's when I got here.
Snap. Man, I wish we could put that on the screen, man. Okay. Yeah.
See that?
Yeah.
Oh, my blood, man.
Wow. Facts, man. Okay. You post that joint up there and everything?
Nah, I ain't posted. You know, so that's for my personal, you know.
Oh,
yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Like, you know,
okay.
I caught the individual.
I'm looking.
Yeah, like I was asking for the ambulance. Yeah. She's recording me. You know what I'm saying? This is how the state of mind of the children in there. Yeah. I'm dying, and she recording me.
Right.
While I'm dying. I'm asking her for help. Call my parents.
Pop up the phone. Let's get this
Let's get this on Instagram. She wants some likes.
Right.
But this, you know, this is what this generation done came to. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Just like I was explaining to a young lady on Facebook, man, you. The definition of bad is a poor decision. Now, you telling me about this, and look at the oxymoron in it. She telling me about, why are you downing out kids and all that? I'm not downing them. I work with kids.
Mm-hmm.
I gave away over 100 coats.
Okay.
I gave away over, you know, 200, matter of fact.
Coat drive.
Yeah, okay. Not only the coats, but tennis shoes. I'm about to give an individual some tennis, 15 pair. His child, his son's mother passed away.
Okay.
He raising his sons by himself. They wear the same size of them. I got hundreds of pair of tennis shoes. I'm about to give him 15 pair of tennis shoes just for between both of his sons.
Right.
Just the loading the light, you know, the lighting the load up on him,
right,
so he can put bills and money us. I mean, you know, money elsewhere.
Well, right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Like these are the type of things I do. You know what I'm saying, off the record. Everything not documented, because I'm saying, if you're doing it from the heart, why you got to record it?
Exactly.
Why you got to show people?
Right. Why keep score on that?
Right, exactly. Why keep score? Why keep score this, I'm saying, when it's from your heart?
Right.
God know what I'm doing, because God sees the gift, the giver, as well as the heart.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
So, I ain't the people, why you do that? Why you ain't doing this? I'm not worried about that. I'm doing my part. I can't worry about the next man.
Right.
I can't worry about what they doing over here or what they doing over there. Let me do this part when I know I'm going to get blessings. I'm not looking for a blessing, but they come anyway.
They come.
You know what I'm saying?
Right. You can't stop. It's going to come. It can come in any other type of form or way. You know, it's definitely going to come. Hey, Fox, you know what I want to do, man? I want to play some of your music, man, if we can. Because I know you said you sent some of it to me.
Yeah, I sent two songs, man. This one. Did you get it?
Go ahead. What?
One of them, the new one. The new one, I don't know if you can get that one. Got that one because it's off my phone. Uh-huh. But I sent you Love Juice and I sent you Teriyaki with Money Bag. And this my artist, Miley Mercury, a street politician affiliate. And the other individual on here is Money Bag Ty.
Which one you like, Teriyaki or
Teriyaki screws up. I'm gonna leave that alone.
Okay.
You can play Love Juice.
I got you. I feel you on that one. So this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna go ahead and take a break. LeBron, put me in the monitors, and we're gonna go ahead and hit this one. Go ahead and explain to tell the people what this one is.
This song called Love Juice featuring Miley Mercury. We call him AKA Captain Hook.
Check it out. 640 Evening Show. Love Juice. Love Juice. Check it out.
We don't play them.
Yellow,
one.
Honey.
Ooh, I love
jokes.
Yeah.
Oh, I love jokes.
Yeah.
I like the leaning, the leaning, the leaning, and I like the shit because I am a I like the zip on that purple body. Yeah. I love the yucky. Miley Mercury, I love jokes.
Yeah.
Nigga feeling high like a pair of shorts.
Sure,
I see a bad train, I hope she is low. Cause I ain't got time to spend game to you.
Sure,
try to tell them that it's nothing that can't do. That you understand now, cause you got jokes.
Oh, shit.
Game ain't dead, it's juiced up.
Oh, shit.
God sent me down here to juice it up.
Juice.
I love the slipping off of my disease and the coating. It really got me so juiced up.
Ooh.
Why bring me right back to trenches to show the whole world that Miley Mercury juicing up? I feel the soul of my codeine. If I keep on sipping, I just might just get stuck. Just show me some gratitude. I'm juicing up with the attitude. Call it JWE. I'm chilling high and I'm feeling so high to the sky and I don't even know what to see. I have scotch from Mars to Pluto to Jupiter. I'm telling you, I've been gone for some days. But maybe I'm feeling some type of way that only a woman can correct the wrong. Maybe I'm feeling some type of way that only a woman can correct the wrong.
Fox sitting in the coop with the doors ajar, listening to Love Juice. Baby girl, you can do what you want to, but when you in the coop, please don't tell me what you don't do.
I got the number for the best fruit. If you want the Love Juice, I can get that too.
I can take off the shoes, you can get the best view. You can see the moon and the stars from the sunroof. That's the panoramic and the see-through. And it feels like a cruise ship and we move. That's the plush talk, I'm talking S6. She wanna hang around the money like a necklace. While I'm sipping in them linen with the left wrist.
If you can't reach my phone, we'll leave a message.
Hello? Might be rubbing on the feet of the next chick. Sitting on the couch while we chilling, watching Netflix.
Yeah.
I know I'm not perfect, but you definitely worth it.
perfect. I'm here at your service. I know that you're nervous. Oh, that's that Mallory Mercury. How could we work this? I think you deserve this. We can't go all the way up. Taking you high as Jupiter. With the essence of Vasa, y'all in your cup.
Back in the day, you know, Love Juice was, you know.
Yeah. That was the devil. Yeah, right. We try to switch that up though.
Right.
It's all about being creative. You know what I'm saying?
I got you.
In the form of art. You know what I'm saying?
No.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. That was tight, man. And what's my man name again?
Mally Mercury.
Mally Mercury.
This dude is just awesome, talented.
DMV cat too?
Yeah, he DMV cat. Okay. You know what I'm saying? Like he's just extraordinary, you know. Just like G5, everybody got their talents.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. G5 he's just so awesome. This guy just.
So it's a team of. So it's about how many?
I got like 10 artists.
Okay.
Right.
Right.
Half of them gone. You know what I'm saying? Because we was a group. Everybody was a group. You
right.
Know what I'm saying? Me and this dude named Preacher Preed. Shout out to Preacher P and turned to a pastor, man.
Okay.
He gave his life to the Lord.
Where?
But me and him used to manage them.
Where are you preaching at?
Out VA.
Oh, in Virginia. VA, okay, yeah. Okay. But go ahead.
Yeah, he decided to just give his life to the Lord because he was just going through a lot of stressful situations and he didn't know how to deal with it, so he wanted to believe in something that's higher than himself, which is God, you know?
Right.
You know, no man can give you what God can give you. You know what I'm saying? That type of energy.
Gotcha.
So he went there. Shout out to P. Yeah, G5 is just something special to me, man. He's like my family. We've been knowing each other for a long time, and this came before the music. You know, mm-hmm. So our relationship came before the music. You know.
Okay.
And he just came home the other day. I went to pick him up from the airport, and man, the guy sounded lovely. He got his head on focus, got his head on right, and that's what we're doing. We ain't doing no negativity stuff. All positive vibes only.
Right.
You know, and we'll see what the naysayers got to say. When we finish doing what we gotta do, you know what I'm saying?
I got you.
But as far as street politicians, we got new shirts coming out, new designs.
You getting my shirt?
Yeah, you definitely gonna get you a shirt. You know what I'm saying? You DJ 6'4". You know what I'm saying? You man, look, you gave me a shot at the title when you know nobody else would. You know what I'm saying? When we did step on that y'all. Did we do step on that y'all? The movie?
With
Rakim Harris?
Nope.
Oh, that must be at Win DC.
Right.
Yeah,
right.
That was at Win DC. Okay, right. That was that. Because we did the Stepped On broadcast at Win DC. That was at.
I think that was what, Kelly?
That was. Because
we.
That was Kelly. Yeah, that was Kelly. Yeah,
right,
yeah.
Right,
because yeah.
We was at Win DC. This is like our third spot from here since we've been on Win DC.
Yeah. This is nice, too, man.
Yeah,
this is real
that.
Nice. You know what I'm saying? This is nice. And the atmosphere is nice.
Right.
Yeah. But, yeah, so what Street Politics is trying to expand on is our networking. The thing that I love about Street Politician and it's growing is that you can be yourself.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we're not politically, you know, correct.
Right.
All the time, you know. But we do tackle issues that dealing with life and substantial growth.
Let me back up right quick. You had mentioned something about your man that was in the game with you that turned pastor. That kind of threw me up with another subject. You familiar with the Mace and the Cameron beef and things like that?
Yes.
What do you think about? You got any opinions on Mace about how he used to do when he, as far as went rapping, then going to preaching and coming back to rapping and stuff like that, and this, you know, how this mess that he's in right now with that?
I think we wasn't born perfect.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? We were made to make mistakes, right. You know, and he didn't make a mistake by making a conscious decision to give his life to the Lord. Mm-hmm. He's just showing you that he being himself, but he still acknowledged God within his heart and his life. Mm-hmm. You know, a lot of people, you know, they're so traditional.
Right.
Like, they can't take that.
Okay.
You know, they can't take it. Just because you accept God in your life don't mean you soft or you changed or anything. You can still live the way you want, but you know now you're living by a set of rules.
Mm-hmm.
Because in the Bible, there's guidelines. You know, that, like, you know, thou shalt not steal, you know what I'm saying? Protect your mother, family, wife, you know, to respect your wife, your kids, you know.
Right.
So he just lined his life up and put it in order.
Right.
And when people do that, I got the highest, most admiration and respect for him. And then he can still, you know, convey his art.
Right.
You know what I mean? Without feeling any backlash, because this is who he is. He's a street politician. You know what I'm saying? He went to being a pastor, but he still put out music. He's not worried about what people saying about him. Because God knows how. You don't know me like I know, like God know me.
Right.
He created me.
And it's funny that you mention that, because, like, I grew up in the Catholic Church, right? And my mom's normally, you know, they raised me up and just like that. And I've been to, like, Baptist churches, too. I visited the Baptist church and stuff. And, you know, watching it, and I'm saying, like, TV and everything, and from relatives, from friends, you know, that preach it to me.
Uh-huh.
And, you know, they preach the word, you know, they say the word to me, and I can hear it over and over. I heard it all throughout my life, right? I'm a big fan of Mace, right? So when he turned pastor, I said, okay, let me listen to this guy, right? Let me listen to him. And I sat there and I listened to him, right? And I listened to a whole bunch of his tapes and his sermons. And I'm gonna tell you, all those people that used to preach it to me, used to tell it to me, I don't care what you thought of Mace or what you thought that he did, but hearing it from him, it clicked to me and it made sense to me, and I was able to follow it and I understood it. Now, he was a messenger that came and delivered this to me, and I heard it from him. So, and whatever he decided to do, like I'm saying, I don't know what he's doing with his life. I'm just saying, like, don't kill the messenger. As long as you get the message out of what somebody's trying to give to you.
Exactly.
And if you can receive that message, then that's the important part. What else did he do with what he do with his life and stuff? You may agree with it or you may don't agree with it, but that's his business. That's his walk. Let him walk his walk. But as long as you were able to receive the message and stuff that was given from him, you know, I think it was all worthwhile. So, you know, like you say, you know, that's God knows his heart, and only he knows, you know, he knows what he's doing. And you know, you can't really, you know, judge nobody, because, you know what I'm saying, because we all come up short.
Mm-hmm.
But then the word of God anyway.
I saw an interview with Mace.
Uh-huh.
He said something that was kind of profound to me, and I'm trying to remember exactly because I don't want to get it wrong.
Right.
What he said, and he was like, why respond? I haven't responded to no negativity in years.
Mm-hmm.
Why give something energy
right.
that don't affect your life?
Mm-hmm.
So, because the guy asked him, they've been dissing you for years, and you never responded. Why did you respond at this particular moment?
Right.
And he said, because the guy threatened my life.
Mm-hmm.
So when you threaten my life as a man, I have to speak up on that.
Okay.
I respected that so much
because
I'm saying, like, why respond to some ignorance?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? For people you know who you are, you know what you're doing, like, he living his life. He living a whole different life. He moved to New York, down to Atlanta.
Right.
This guy been, you know, through the trenches. You know what I'm saying? But people don't know what he been through and want to be judgmental of that.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That's what I did. I kind of detest that, you know. But I love what he said. So why respond and give energy to something that don't, you know, it don't affect you at all.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right. But you draw the line when you talk, when you challenge him.
Yeah, when you challenge a man's manhood, any real man
right.
going to speak up. You know right. what I'm saying? Just like I've been to plenty of jobs.
Yeah.
And they talk to me in the camp. Look, bro. You ain't going to talk to me like that. You know what I'm saying? Look, I told one guy, I was working a construction job. And, he asked me, he said, you at work today? I said, yes, sir. I'm working. You ain't on that work if you ain't on my goddamn scaffold. Right.
Yeah.
I was first coming home, you know, I'm fresh out of the game. I don't know.
Right.
And then to have a Caucasian talking to you like that, I said, what, excuse me? I said, look here, sir. I respect you. And I'm before I got to say that, he said, I don't want to hear a goddamn thing. Get up on my scaffold. Next thing you know, it led one thing led to another. You know what I'm saying? I got five, basically.
Right.
And he got hit in the head with a mortar bucket. You know what I'm saying? But because I don't allow no disrespect.
Right.
From, you know, I was trying to be respectful.
Respectful, right.
You know what I'm saying? But he was taking it somewhere else. You know what I'm saying? And me seeing him treat other people, you know, wrong, mm-hmm. especially Spanish guys, stuff like that, I had to speak up. So yeah. I spoke up and he said what he said and it led to one thing. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. But I just say that to say this, that any man who has integrity about himself, not going to allow no one to walk over him.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Any man, he don't have to be tough. Everybody mm-hmm. got this perception that you got to be this tough old. Nah, you got to be tough.
Right. Yeah, right. I got you. True talk, real talk, street politician, right? We here, 640 Evening Show, right here on Box Power, 37.3. And we got some more music that I think I'm going to play from him. You said that other one with was too grimy for it.
This 640, we drinking champagne, you know what I'm saying? Right. So, look, you can play it, you know what I'm saying? It's called Teriyaki featuring Moneybagg Ty. He signed to Unified or Die Records.
Not too grimy.
Nah, it ain't too grimy.
It ain't
no sexual content, none of that in there.
Check this one out, ladies and gentlemen. This one is Teriyaki?
Yeah.
Teriyaki. The flavor. Check it out. 6-4 Evening Show. Don't y'all go nowhere. We right here. Keep right here locked. 6-4 Evening Show. Put me in the monitors. We gonna hear this
gotta,
one
right here. I gotta give you the streets. Kill your lens. This drink deep. You know what I'm saying? The streets kill your lens. I made one called Be Like That. I'm talking to tell the story about when I got shot. Uh-huh. Oh, man. My mother cried when she heard it. I ain't gonna let my mother hear no more music. Why you make that song?
Check this one out, ladies. This is Teriyaki, and I'm going to try to put it on here for you, for my listeners right here.
Stupid dope. Me and Stupid dope, the life of the party. Yes. Not to sound cocky, but she called me Poppy when she in the kitchen cooking teriyaki. And she can cook, don't need a book. She can measure it with just one look. Whip all that cake, that's that Audi I ate. And one push of a button, then all of a sudden, catch me in the back, thumbing racks. Man, the script jumping like jumper jacks. They trapping out the Uber, pumping packs. Niggas running plays like they running back. She sees the stack, she wants some of that. But nah, boo, you get none of that.
Nah.
This is where it's thumping at. Once you win the trap, ain't no coming back.
Trap spot around the corner from me, whip a teriyaki. Riding around town in the whip is foreign, so you know the whip color teriyaki. You don't wanna fall out, tryna make a dope move, tryna push the teriyaki. Got a trap queen in the trap house right now, whipping up the teriyaki. Got a 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 whipping up the teriyaki. You don't wanna fall out, tryna make a dope move, tryna push the teriyaki. Got a trap queen in the trap house right now, whipping up.
Got the trap queen in my trap house right now, whipping up teriyaki. Got pounds in here, got work in here, got choppers in here. Don't tell nobody when that little pistol don't scare nobody. AR-15 tear through your body. Better get back, watch that nigga scram. I'm the butcher man, not that nigga plan. I'm the baker man, come and get you brand. Street pharmacist, come and get you Zans. Heard a pussy nigga coming for the bag. Youngin' gon' be leaving with the ambulance. Started hand to hand, you could place an order. Come and get a zip, come and get a quarter. I'm in Cap Heights, pushing teriyaki. Right across the border, chickens getting slaughtered. I don't play with work, I don't play with beats. Treat it like the block, we gon' play for keeps. Call me Dwayne Wade, boy, I stay with heat. Always in the field, like the major league. Moving them things, it ain't a thing to me. You gon' fall off, trying to play with me. It's gon' be some bodies in your trap spot. Take the teriyaki out your trap spot.
Put your man on the trap spot, round the corner from me. Whip a teriyaki, riding around town in the whippers form. So you know the whip color teriyaki. You don't wanna fall off, try and make a dope move. Try and push the teriyaki. Got a trap queen in the trap house right now. Whipping up the teriyaki. Gotta whip up the teriyaki.
It's gonna be some bodies in your trap spot. Take the teriyaki out your trap spot.
Put your man on the trap spot. Round the corner from me, whip a teriyaki. Riding around town in the whippers form. So you know the whip color teriyaki. You don't wanna fall out, try and make a dope move. Try and push the teriyaki. Got a trap queen in the trap house right now. Whipping up the teriyaki. Gotta 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 whipping up the teriyaki. You don't wanna fall out, try and make a dope move. Try and push the teriyaki. Got a trap queen in the trap house right now. Whipping up the teriyaki.
What's up? We back here live on 640 Evening Show. Before we go any further, let me let y'all know about this. Just to let you know about Star Imports. This is one of the sponsors up here of the 640 Evening Show. Star Imports is the home of the boutique styling buying experience. Star Imports Motors has 50 years of automobile industry. Star Imports is in Camp Springs, right off Branch Avenue, behind the Red Lobster. Star Imports provide the personal attention you deserve and treat you with the utmost respect. Bad credit, no problem. We have credit restoration. What? You can't get me to do this after I've been drinking champagne. Bad credit, no problem. We have restoration programs to help you. Credit application is on www.starimports.com.
Be quiet.
Star Imports does bank, in-house financing, and buy back, and buy here, and pay here. The vehicle you want is not inventory, no problem. They specialize in financing you the perfect car. Star Imports donates a portion of all its sales given back to the D.C., Maryland, and Virginia in charities such as D.C. STEM Network, National Museum of African American History and Culture, and Girls Incorporated to help develop kids into becoming successful contributors to society and to help support institutions that preserve history. So come down here to Star Imports right off Branch Avenue, right beside the Red Lobster, and get yourself a car, just like my man General the Fox. He rolling that big car outside there. Yeah. That he got. I'm saying, come down here to Star Imports. Yeah. You definitely can get you a car. Nightmares. Let them know about the toy drive.
Toys for Tots 2017 toy drive for the kids on 4711 Auth Road, Suitland, Maryland. Drop-off deadline December 20th, or donate to a local charity at Live Music Foundation. 100% towards the toy drive. Do it for the kids.
Do it for the kids. Come on here, donate yourself some toys down here.
That's right.
Fox, you got a little toy drive and stuff going on yourself, man. Matter of fact, before you know, I want you to give out your social media and let the folks know about your little toy drive that you got going on.
Yeah,
too,
yeah, we got a good toy drive connected with Cheers on Martin Luther King Avenue by the big chair.
Okay.
Just come in there, drop the toy into the box, you know what I'm saying? It will be donated properly to the kids in the community that's with a need. You can find me on Foxtrap08, that's Instagram. On Facebook, I'm Jonathan Fox. And on Twitter, I'm BigFox_08. Everything you'll see, my shirts, books, music, things I'm doing in the community. And if you want to, I got a website, but I don't want to host it yet because I don't have the material on there.
I got you.
I'll show you after the show.
The bubbles got you burping?
Yeah, the bubbles got that. You see what we drinking, man? You see right. we drinking Bel Air. I was like, oh, okay, this one is. I would have brought me a bottle. Yeah, but yeah, so we doing this for the community and try to, you know, like I said, close that gap that society don't forgot about.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like I told a female earlier, won't you just come to the community and walk with me? Mm-hmm. And then you will get a sense of, just because your child doing good don't mean everybody else's child doing good.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Because we still dealing with addiction. We're dealing with mental health problems that's right. in our community right as of now.
Yeah.
You know, and these are the issues that nobody wants to address.
Gotcha.
You know what I'm saying? So, you know, we're trying to close that gap a little bit, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Just one by one, one by one.
Right.
One by one. Street politicians, general, big fox, y'all.
Yeah. So, definitely want to get with that. Drop off some toys. Is it still Toys for Tots? You know,
at 1222 Martin Luther King Avenue, Southeast, Big Cheers, by the Big Cheers, Southeast. You can drop your toys off. Drop your toys off right there. And if you want to volunteer as well, right. Hit me at streetpoliticians @gmail.com to pass out toys or whatever you want to do. And we'll get back to you ASAP.
Okay, that's what's up. That's what's up, man. And come back and, you know, with us before, like, we got like, what, two more shows before the end of the year, man. So, you know, with Christmas and all that type of stuff. So, you know, we definitely be doing our things.
Man, I definitely want to come back and visit y'all. I told y'all it's always a pleasure being in good company and people who being supportive of individuals, you know, like such as myself, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So I come back and bless you. Hopefully I have some new music. Bring my artists with me.
And what's that music that you sent me?
Kill Your Lynch.
Yeah. Can I, you wanna run that one?
Yeah, you can run it. Did you receive it?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, run it.
I want y'all to check this one out. This one is called Kill Your Lynch, right?
Yeah. Here. Big Fox, Street Politician General featuring King Los.
We definitely got to run this one. Check this one out, ladies and gentlemen. This one right here is called Kill Your Lineage.
Yeah, the streets will kill your lineage.
The streets will kill your lineage. Check this one out. Put me in a monitor test there, Ron.
Well, I'm Big Fox, I'm next up. Man, fuck Trill, just wanna rest us.
Yeah.
Get my niggas live without the handcuffs. When you're getting money, they can't stand us. Hey, niggas better vest up, cause we going to war and it's just us.
Yeah.
But them 223s are fucking chest up. Get you dressed up so you can rest up.
Work.
Through another game, don't test us. The streets turn us too great, finesse us. Niggas shot with me, come back with me. And believe me, home, I'ma bless ya. My real men need to stand up. If you got a problem, nigga, man up. This is a game of chess, not checkers. Cause you jump mine, I want just us. Emotional scars on my back tatted. It broke my heart when my homie read it. Poor niggas just trying to live lavish. The traffic came from them bad habits. I know these niggas feel some type of way, so you get on Twitter when you type away. Niggas mad and it be the case. I can see the hate all in the face.
Let's go.
So I pull up my coupe stunt. My young niggas want shoot some. That beef shit. It ain't about nothing. How you think they got names like Trigger and Gunner? Free my hogs, that Mr. Summer. I'm home now when I'm doing numbers. The same niggas used to talk behind my back. The same niggas that run from us.
As for me at my house, I'm not bothering about what men may say. When in 5 years none of our people have died, and there's never been a casket rolled through people's temple, when 24 times in this year, and the year's not out, they've brought the dead in the doors, and they've gone out alive. when they've dropped dead in their seat, they've been resurrected. I'm not bothering about what you have to say. I'm not bothering about your opinions. I'm living in the actual conscious presence of God in the earth plane. You see, I know where God is. He's in my hands. He's in my feet. He's in my body.
They call him your honor, but where was the honor? These niggas some bitches. I trump up them charters so niggas can bargain to please the mission. Facts. Put Donald in office, this nigga be talking like he the commissioner. But we the militia. Pussy not me the mortician. I give a fuck if you with them, but if you with them, you bout to be ducking them midges. Nigga, you fucking with Pep and I fuck with them bitches that go out and fuck for a living. The devil's a liar, they made an empire off me and my niggas. Capitalism by capturing niggas and packing the prison. Let's whack all these bitches. Been buzzing for light years, I'm about to zap all these bitches. All they hoes get the woody, Kylie Bronner on the hoodie. Bitch was looking Megan Goody. Twerk a pussy, she can roll out. You a nigga with a hoe's mouth. 45, show his whole scout.
The streets will get you together or get you for love. It's two type of dudes, that's by us to sell.
I'm miracle whipping.
You dudes need to catch up or move in them coops with them all, bro.
Yes. If you talking about cheese, you need to talk cheddar. Matter of fact, you talk too much, need to talk less.
When it comes to that bread, I'm trying to make breakfast. Is I'm humping her, I never met her. Just look at my fella, stepping in my jealous. Got these niggas jealous, all these niggas fellas. Ain't nothing you can tell them, fly like a feather.
In the sky like propellers, we get you together.
Shit shots through, you'll never get cold in this weather. When it comes to this work, you know it's no telling. You say you a shooter, we know that you wellin'. You beefin' with me, then we beefin' forever.
That's what it is. The streets will kill your lineage.
Now in tune to the hottest internet radio show east side of the Potomac, the 640 Evening Show. You're now in tune.
Street politics, man. That was cool. That's what's up, man.
I appreciate that, man.
Hell yeah, man. What a way to end the last one, man. And that one here, I would definitely have to edit that a little bit and everything, but that was deep. Those lyrics and stuff was deep, man. I was definitely feeling that, man. Yeah. So yeah. That was number three, right? Yeah,
that was number three.
Okay. So who was that?
That was me and one of my artists, Philly King Los. This guy's a scroll, very, very humble. I got him. I got him working with me in the streets as well, talking to people, networking.
Okay.
You know, he's like one of the few individuals that's willing to work. Okay. Willing to show his worth, you know what I'm saying, like that he dedicated to it. Because, you know, I ran into a lot of people say, man, I'm trying to be with the street politicians. Yeah. Look, we ain't doing a negative over here, bro.
Right.
We out here helping the community over here.
Right.
So if you come over here, you got to be serious.
Yeah.
Like, just like the Black Panthers were serious, you know what I'm saying? I want to get street politicians to the point where we a household name.
Right.
You know, where women can say, look, I'm going to take you to a street politician mentor.
Definitely gonna have to pass that one to my man DJ320. That's my son. He got his thing going on too. That's definitely one of his lanes and stuff. Definitely gonna let him check that one out.
Wow.
Yes, absolutely. Fox, and I would not be remiss if I wouldn't have before you go, I have to ask you about this, man. Let me know what you think about this presidency and Donald Trump and all this stuff that's going on with all the sexual harassment cases and stuff like that. And he haven't had his turn yet.
Oh. I think Donald Trump, you know, let me. I don't want to be politically correct. I think the guy's a puppet. You know, he. Did you see what he said?
He said so much stuff.
He's like, I visit Puerto Rico and the president of the Virgin Islands. Oh, bro, that's United States territory.
Right.
That was the 72 Union in 1960.
A hard drive with the Mazer.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That was the 72 Union to the United States. So you would know who's the president of the Virgin Islands, and when that's United States territory, just
right.
like Puerto Rico is United States territory, accepted to the Union in 1940, you know what I'm saying? So our president is not that bright. Well, their president, because I don't consider him no president.
You don't consider him no president?
No. I mean, this is the guy more so a businessman. Mm-hmm. You know, he doesn't have the, I ain't gonna say tenacity, but I'm gonna say the...
expertise.
Exactly. You know, to run a country, just, there's so many issues that, you know, we're dealing with, you know, especially that he's not tackling. Right. He's concerned about, I mean, Kim Jong is a threat, mm-hmm. you know what I'm saying, to the world.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But on more down the ladder issues, he concerned about things that don't affect us as a population. You see what I'm saying?
A whole bunch of stuff that he
thought. Yeah, a whole bunch of stuff. Right, you know what
right,
I mean?
Because he got his opinion about the NFL, about stuff like that, when he's supposed to be, like, running the country and stuff. I mean, a whole bunch of other stuff that's necessary. Having us progressive.
Why is you chiming in on the NFL? Yeah. When the job rate is still, the unemployment rate is still high. Why is you chiming on the NFL when the homeless rate is gone up?
Right.
You know what I'm saying? They taking people homes at a rate right now. It's not broadcasted, but behind the scenes, like, people out here suffering.
Yeah.
Like, you see, matter of fact, perfect example. Every store you go to, hey, bro, can you spend some change?
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I can't even get in the damn 7-Eleven without, hey, bro, you got some change? No, I ain't got no change. You know what I'm saying? It's irritating to me, you know what I'm saying? And then when I try, I'm telling you, like, we need more education. We need more education. That's what I keep trying to promote. You know what I have a guy that's working with me named Ken Williams. He's the CEO of a tech company. He told me anytime I need him, he's available when we get this nonprofit going so we can get kids in there to teach them about technology because that's the future. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, most definitely. Most definitely.
I had a spot where we were going to do a fundraiser on Howard Road in Southeast, but they just sold that for $20 million. So, you know, they're selling out all the property. Even our mayor in D.C., I feel as though it's not doing us, just doing residents a disservice with the regentrification. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? I checked for an apartment the other day. The lady told me $1,700.
How many bedrooms?
A one-bedroom. I said, that's mortgage.
Wow.
On a rent.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You telling me... Down Southwest look like the new Northwest. Like, Southwest is beautiful.
Right. I saw it.
Yeah. I called that lady to get an apartment. Guess what she said? $3,200. Who can afford this? You are.
Not us.
You are confined to what you are paid. You know what I'm saying? So if you make $28,000 a year, guess what you're confined to? Southeast. Yeah. That's a low income. They just built Archer Park over there off of.
The Fox. They're coming to get that too. They're coming to get that too. Trust me, they're coming to get that.
We gotta come together. You know what? Yeah. The power that we have is men. Like, we don't trust each other as blacks. We don't trust each other.
What was the lapse in that, man? What happened to that? Why we can't?
I preach this all the time. Like, people keep. I blame the streets for a lot of stuff. You know why? Because it gave you a false sense of hope. And that's not that. You ain't gonna get a million. You ain't gonna be a millionaire selling dimes.
Mm-hmm.
You ain't gonna be a millionaire selling 20. Yeah. Well, I see social media all the time too. Oh, I'm bossing up. You ain't a boss until you hire somebody. Take them out their current predicament and help them.
What they be able to do with the dimes, man, they can get a down payment for a car, but they won't be able to support the car. Eventually, that car will get taken. Right?
And guess what? They end up being in debt.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Because that's how the United States just ran off of credit because nothing is backing the United States currency right now. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So when they go ahead, you know, as what I read in the J.P. Morgan bank book, mm-hmm. bank book is 2,000 pages, J.P. Morgan.
Okay.
Look it up. 2,000 pages. What I read, long as America in debt, that's what keeps the country running. If there's no debt, there's no money for them.
Right.
You see what I'm saying?
I feel you, yeah.
So.
Interesting. Yeah,
I mean, you got to pay attention to economic development. You know what I'm saying? I'm not on the street, dude. I read as well.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I have
hundreds
of books. You know what I'm saying? When I was in prison, that's all I did.